Getting Things Done. It's a book by David Allen, and it's a very nice productivity setup that I want to showcase in ClickUp with. Diving right in to the capture perspective, what we need to do is make a list view of what we want for this to be. So essentially, capture, clarify, organize, reflect, and engage is the five steps of GTD. So first of all, we need a place to capture things. So we go into a new list view. Let's just make an example here. So I'm starting from scratch and making a test list here. And then what you want to make sure is that you go into your Click Apps here and add the custom field. So I have it in these two right now. So I want to make sure that we have all of these selected. Then if I go back in here and see within this space, this new test list that I made is going to allow me to open this and change the custom fields here. So what I want to do is add or edit these custom fields, delete this, and then from here, add a few different select fields here. So first, what we're going to want to do is make this all go away. And then I would recommend doing dropdowns, which is similar to select in Notion. And I'm going to call this priority field type dropdown. And then let's do a couple different ones. Let's do priority one and another one. Priority two, and another one, and then future, then create, and then another drop down, which will be task group. So let's do the different like life buckets that we have. So let's do work, side hustle, housekeeping, or growth. Let's do growth and life. So I'm gonna add personal colors to them. And obviously, if you wanted to, you can do the same thing here. And then one more field here would be a checkbox. So let's just do status, whether it's completed or not. So those are the custom fields that you need. So then if we go to the list view here or the table view, it's up to you which one you want. And what we can do is we can group it by the different types of custom fields, which would be priority. So for example, say this test task has a priority one. We save that change here to change the grouping. Let me add another task that is test two, and then change it so that there is a priority two here. Let me do another one, just a future thinking idea, and make this a future option. Now, in order to make this actually work from a practical perspective, we have a few different options. We can go here and group it by a priority setup here as well. But until we're sure about what it is, what we can actually do is add an extra layer to this and go capture. So this is one where we can make it so that essentially, until we're sure of what it is, we can have a capture or inbox option. So basically, say I add a new task and do captured inbox task, and I change it so that this is what it is, or I can change the name of this to inbox, whatever your preference is on it. This is the first part. So essentially, we could have a capture spot here. So this is a captured inbox task from a top-down approach. We can see that the most important things on your task list are going to be on the top, and at the very bottom is what you're going to have from a capture perspective. So anytime you want to capture a different task, that's what you could do. And in order to make it easier on yourself, you could change from a filter perspective what you'd have here. So I know in Notion that it's really nice that I could segment this into different sections, but I could do different views here. So that's, let's say I wanted to just really quick duplicate this as a list and have this be the inbox. So I could filter this so that the priority is inbox. So having it so that the filter is set so that the priority is inbox makes it so that everything you capture here would just be your inbox. And then what you could do is have it so that you could filter it, or you could group it by different things like due date or something else that you'd want to do, like tags, or you can tag it to specific types of things for later. Or you can do something like, you know, let's do the task group so that your inbox would have the ability to, if we duplicated some things here and made this task a part of the work test group, then we could at least capture it in a more specific spot. So this is your inbox area. And then when it comes to the other list view, we can change the name of this to GTD actions and pin it as well as the inbox. And then from a filtering standpoint on the GTD action section, we can set it so that status, which is that checkbox thing that we made, is not checked. And then we could show from a columns perspective, the checkbox that we made. In the show and hide section, we can show this custom field status as well as the task group here. So we can have it be filtered so that it shows stuff that's not checked off. So then when I check something off like this, it could finish it. Then we can do something like adding this to the priority one to showcase priority one field once again. And you have the option here to hide or open closed tasks as well. Now then, in order to see a view of what you've previously done, let's get a new calendar view here. Let's call it calendar. You can pin this as well. And then essentially, once you set this due date to something like today, you'd be able to see in your calendar that task on that day, and then also be able to see it in your home view as well in the to-do section. So essentially, the way that this system would work is that in your inbox, you'd capture different tasks on this page into whatever you want. So you just quickly would either go to this page and have it only be an inbox area, or you can go here and just have the captured tasks come here and be like, example, captured work task, and then I could set it to work. And then after you capture, then you could be like, okay, when is the due date? Let's say it's due tomorrow. And the clarification section is figuring out whether it's a project, action, or reference. So this is a task. We've already done the clarification. Now organization is putting into the right place, like adding dates to your calendar. So I've already added it to tomorrow. You can delegate it to other people if you had other people on your team. And then another part of the organization is saying what priority it is and what task group it is. So I'm gonna say it is a priority one. So you have a few different options. Either you can drag it up here like this, or if you wanted to, you could also do show columns, show hide, and then add the priority one here. Now it's up to you. Obviously you're gonna have it be in both situations, but I can just quickly do this and set it to a priority one. So then it would move up here. And in a second, this will re-update. So now we have two priority tasks here. If I set this guy to Saturday and close it, now what you can do here is select something like due date and sort it so that you have it grouped, so that if we do a proper sorting here, the closer task to your timeline, so today's task, is obviously more close to being needed to complete than the Saturday task. So we'd prioritize priority one as well as what is closer in time. Now, for some reason, if you were going to focus on specific types of task groups, that's what this is for. So if we wanted to, we could sort it so that from a priority standpoint, if we do sorting, we can have this sort be cleared. So if we go and look at the properties here, we have it top down. And then a nice and easy way to do some sort of weekly reflection would be to make a priority one task that would be weekly reflection GTD, and then let me do control enter to open it. And if we wanted to, we can make the task group reflection or GTD, whichever one you want. So this option could be at the very bottom or at the very top. It's what you want, but just knowing that you need to do that reflection is important. So let's take this option and go and add it to this. And then what we could do is have it be a recurring task. So we can set a recurring task. So like every Sunday, we would have a recurring task forever that would have a GTD review. And then you can set it so that you would basically create a new task and have it be templated out so that every single week you'd know, I need to do my weekly GTD reflection so that I can process things that are in the inbox and move it out. The nice thing about ClickUp is if you don't want to look at the future stuff, you can toggle these on or off. If you just want to work and you don't want to see the inbox right now and just focus on priority one, you can toggle these on and off easily and have a complete GTD setup in ClickUp. Now, if you want to have another setup that's pretty productive, check out this video. You'll improve your productivity there as well.